This year, the Jericho Congregational Church partnered with Food for the Hungry to support the community of Guazameda. We'd like to invite you to consider sending a Christmas gift to our new sister church. The community of Guazameda is in need of water purification and an early childhood education facility. These gifts would be an incredible blessing to the people of Guazameda. It's JCC's goal to raise $3,500 to make these gifts a reality. Donations can be made on JCC's giving page by selecting Guazameda Christmas Gift. Thank you for considering a contribution.
Good evening and welcome to Christmas Eve candlelight worship with us here at Jericho Congregational Church. We are excited to be together with you, and I know for most of you that means we're together with you at home tonight. So thank you for making this a time and part of your evening. We are encouraged about the chance to be together and to truly worship this evening and to receive the gifts God has gifted us on Christmas Eve. Tonight marks the culmination of our Advent season, and so that means we are lighting the fifth and last Advent candle tonight. And to do that, as a call to worship this evening, the Hassler family is together with us. And so I want to invite them up now to light the fifth candle tonight.
Scripture reading for tonight is taken from John's Gospel, chapter 1, 1-5, 9-14. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. The true light that gives light to everyone was coming into the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who did receive him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God, children born not of natural descent, nor of human decision or of a husband's will, but born of God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We've seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. Tonight, as we reach the end of this Advent season, may we be ready to recognize and receive Jesus as the true light of the world. Amen. Amen.
Thank you. source and ending He of the things that are, that have been, and that future years shall see. Heights of heaven adore Him, angel hosts His praises sing, powers, dominions before Him, and extol our God and King. Let no tongue on earth be silent, every voice in concert evermore and evermore. Christ to thee with God the Father and the Holy Ghost to thee, hymn and chant and high thanksgiving and unwearied praises be. Honor, glory, and dominion and eternal victory evermore and still we see thee lie above thy deep and dreamless sleep. The silent stars go by, yet in thy dark street shineth the everlasting light. The hopes and fears of all silently the wondrous gift is given. So God imparts to human hearts the blessings of His hand. No ear may hear His coming, but in this world of sin, Christ enters in. O holy child of Bethlehem, descend on us, we pray. Cast out our sin and enter in, be born in us today. We hear the Christmas glad tidings tell. Oh, come to us, abide with us, our Lord Emmanuel.
Oh, come to us, abide in us, our Lord Emmanuel. As we come before the Lord, the God of the universe, giving our praise as an offering to Him, it is only natural that we also come before the Lord in confession. When we approach the throne of God in worship, we see also how desperately we are in need of him. So let's take a few moments today in a time of silent confession, and then we will have a corporate confession, which you'll see on the screen, and you will be able to join in that with us. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for the gift of your Son, Jesus Christ, that you dared to enter our world 2,000 years ago as a tiny baby who would bear the burden of our sin. Lord, we come before you today and we confess our sin. Join me now in the corporate confession of sin. O Father, we are gathered before you, the maker of heaven and earth, whose chosen dwelling place is with the broken and contrite, to confess that we have sinned in thought and word and deed. We have not loved you with all our heart and soul. We have not loved you with all our mind and strength. We have not even loved our neighbor as ourselves. In your mercy, deepen our sorrow for the wrong we have done and for the good we have left undone, so that we may hate our sin with a holy hatred. But please, Father, do not leave us in sorrow. With you, O Lord, there is forgiveness. In your mercy, restore the joy of our salvation so that we may love you with a holy love. Amen. And join with me now in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Tonight is Christmas Eve at JCC, and I know on a normal Christmas Eve there would be many of you in the pews here tonight, and we would be anticipating two special ways that we are accustomed to enter into worship tonight. Two gifts that always mark for us this Christmas Eve service at JCC. And those, of course, are the gifts of candlelight and the gifts of communion. For those of you who are worshiping at home tonight, let me invite you now, if you've prepared bread and cup tonight to enter into communion, and if you've prepared candles to experience the time of candlelight at the end of this service, to go ahead and gather those things now so that you're ready to worship alongside us here in just a few moments. But before we enter into the experience of those things, the receiving of those things, I do want to take a few minutes and spend some time in the Gospel of John, chapter 1. If you have your Bibles, you can open there to chapter 1, verse 1. I've chosen this passage tonight because I think it proclaims to us the very same gifts we intend to celebrate on Christmas Eve. John's gospel begins by telling us, firstly, about the word of God gifted to us in the form of illumination, in light. And then John goes on to explain that the gift of God's word becomes even more manifest. It comes in yet another gift, and that one is in the form of incarnation, the taking on of flesh. So we have these dual gifts, illumination and incarnation. Let me pray for us now as we hear the word of God, that we would receive the coming of God to us now, both in Jesus as the light of the world and the word made flesh. Let's pray. Lord, we need you to come to us tonight. Lord, we need you to reveal yourself to us tonight. And Lord, we ask, we depend upon your presence and your power as we come to the word of God. Lord, may it meet us where we are at. May it overcome and overturn our darkness. Lord, may your word reveal to us the glory of who you are made manifest in Jesus the Christ who comes to us tonight. May the words of my mouth as I preach, may the meditations of all of your church's heart tonight be pleasing in your sight. Pray these things in the name of the word, the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. John begins his gospel in this way. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning, and through him all things were made. Without him, nothing was made that has been made. Because in him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. Tonight I want to proclaim along with John the good news, the gospel that we have received. And that is that Jesus Christ is the life and the light of creation. Jesus is the gift of God's illumination. God has chosen to send to us himself in the form of light. And it's a helpful visual for us tonight. On one of the longest nights of the year, at the end of one of the longest years in memory, we're told tonight that Jesus' light shines despite all of that darkness. As it says in verse 5 here, the darkness cannot, nor will the darkness ever be able to overtake, to overcome the brilliance of who Jesus is. And I want us to sit with that truth for a moment. If you have a Christ candle lit there at your home, if you have a candle there with you, take a moment to look into its light right now. And as you do that, I would invite you to prayerfully invite the light of Christ into the dark places of this year, into the dark places of this present moment, whatever those might be for you. It's not uncommon for the month of December, for these last weeks of the year, to be difficult ones. They're not always restful or worshipful or easy as they come to us. And I think it's okay for us to acknowledge that this evening. But as we're aware of the darkness in our world, perhaps the darkness in our own life, the heaviness of those things, we're told to remember that Jesus is the maker of all things, John says. Jesus is the one who supplies life to all things. And Jesus is the light of all mankind. Lord Jesus, would you give our hearts the ability to trust in the resilience of your light? That it is unending, it is unchanging, and it is present where we are tonight. At the end of our service tonight, we have the chance to take the light of the world, that symbol of Jesus Christ, in our candles. And as we pass that to one another, we will be confessing and professing the hope we have in Jesus to light up, to illuminate our dark places. But before we do that, John wants us to confront what is a difficult reality in verses 9, 10, and 11. His gospel tells us that even with all of the brilliance and illumination of who Jesus is and the glory of God that he possesses, John says we still struggle to recognize Jesus as he brings those things to us. We are impaired in that way. Let me read to you those three verses, 9 through 11. It says, "The true light that gives light to everyone was coming into the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him." If the good news of John's gospel is that Jesus is the light of the world, come to us, and in a light that cannot be overtaken, the bad news that is presented to us here is that the human condition is fundamentally one of blindness. We're like a golem in the cave, right? Shut up in utter darkness, hiding ourselves from the sun. John says we're like kids mesmerized by the empty glow of the television screen, so that when a real human being enters the same room, we don't even register their presence. John says, in a similar way, we are deeply unacquainted, unfamiliar, unreceptive to the light God has sent to us. The light of God that comes into our world, we have not recognized. And because we have not recognized him, John says in verse 11, we have no capacity to receive him, to receive that gift of light. You and I are in need of an encounter with the presence and the glory of God that is capable of overcoming that condition, that blindness in who we are. We need an encounter with God that can overcome our ability to miss him when he comes to us. And tonight, this is where the good news of the gospel gets even better than it is as it begins here in John 1. Because as it continues, we're told that the presence of God comes into creation not only as the light of the world, but as the carol we sing goes on to say, the presence, the word of God, comes now with flesh appearing. Right, the glory of God comes in a second way, in a fuller and more manifest tangible sense in the gift of incarnation. Look at verse 14. It says, "So the Word became flesh, and he made his dwelling among us." Right? So that in the Word made flesh, we see the glory. We see the glory of the one and only Son who has come from the Father, full of grace and truth. This is an unparalleled, this is an unsurpassed gift. And for the past month, we have been singing that carol. It's been in our prelude this evening. It's been in our worship this month of Advent, right? Come, come, Emmanuel. Right? It's a hymn of waiting, longing for the presence of God to be revealed to us. But tonight, in our Christmas Eve worship, right, John's gospel would have us not only waiting for that coming, but he indicates that we're meant also to give way to a time of receiving tonight. Because tonight, in this gospel, we proclaim that God has indeed come to his people. In Jesus, God has come with flesh on his bones. And we are here tonight to receive that coming. We're here tonight because we need to receive that coming. Right? We need to make space in our lives for this child who will interrupt and disrupt our loneliness and our isolation and our darkness and our blindness. Tonight we ask for the glory of God's only Son to dwell with us. To be near with us, Lord Jesus. So before we get to the time of illumination this evening, before we try to sing and to worship and to see by the light of Jesus, we come first to commune with his body. We come first to be received by the Lord himself at his table. And to receive the gift of the incarnation there. So let me invite you, if you're here in the sanctuary or if you are at home, to go ahead and take those elements of communion now. To gather the plate with the bread and the cup. And I would invite you to take those things and as you offer them to those you are with tonight, to simply say, "This is the Word of God become flesh for you." And then hold them in your hands. We're going to hold these gifts before we take them into our bodies. And as we do that, Karen's going to play for us. And I would invite you to just use these next few minutes to listen, to receive, to consider the gift that we hold before us. Let's listen and worship now. Thank you. gospel says that this is the Word of God sent into our world. This is the Word of God sent in the form of a human body so that we might see what a human being filled with the glory, filled with the grace and truth of who God is, what that looks like to live from and out of. Jesus is God's gift of incarnation, his gift of flesh to us. And we're told that in the same body that was a child born to us in Bethlehem, that same gift of incarnation, that same body, would later be gifted and given up and lifted up and broken for us. That same child would later shed his blood to wash over us. And the promise, John's gospel says, the reason that the Word of God has become flesh and dwelt among us is so that we might receive him, and so that everyone who receives him might become as Jesus is. We might become a child born not of natural descent, not of human decision, not of a husband's will, but we might become children born of God. If you want to know and be known by God in that way, to be his son or his daughter, then these gifts have been given to you and me tonight. Take and receive them now. Would you pray with me? Lord, these are pure gift. They are grace to us. We have not deserved you to create in the first place, you to redeem, you to illuminate, you to come to us in human flesh and then to give your life away for us. But Lord, we are grateful. And we are glad to be welcome at your table tonight. May we be your children. May we find ourselves in you, Jesus, tonight. In your name we pray. Amen. We're going to move into the last part of our service now. And in just a moment, I'm going to go take a candle and light it from the Christ candle, and the lights are going to come down here. I'd invite you to get your candles out at home or wherever you are, and also to maybe bring the lights down in the room where you're singing. And we're going to pass that light to one another, and in the same way that we've shared the body of Christ with one another and said, this is the Word of God made flesh for you, as you pass that light to one another, would you say, this is the light of the world? Frank and Carol, do you guys want to come up and lead us now?
The world in solemn stillness lay to hear the angels sing. For lo, the days are hastening on, by prophet seen of old, when with the
receive the light of Christ tonight, the life of Christ incarnate tonight. And may you receive these words of the angels from Luke 2. May they send us forth into this night together. The angel said to them, the shepherds in the field, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you, and he is Christ the Lord." Amen.